I would say it was as unified as white on rice.
Okay.
Now, there were a few that were not unified allegedly.
Mm-hmm.
There were strings because of their indebtedness to somebody.
Right.
So you had that problem. You had, as I spoke to one lady, I'm sorry, I can't take credit for this, as my sister spoke to one lady who was originally from there and around my age, and she ended up with a graduate degree and married to the superintendent of schools, I believe it was in Spartanburg County. And so my sister was gently asking her, you know, how did you get so motivated for this? Because her father was not really active at that time. And she said, oh yes, he was. He could not come out because we had a juke joint and he's selling corn whiskey. But a lot of that corn whiskey money went to the treasurer for use in helping this case get through. So you had that type of quiet support. And in some cases, you had people who were being paid to go back. For example, our house was burned, and it was arson. And the person who torched it happened to be a black man, whom my father had built a house and let him live in free, trying to help him get on his feet. He was paid $25 to torch the house. Okay? So you did have that kind of situation. But now, on the other hand, there were threats and fears of my father's life. And black men came together. We didn't know it in our family that this is what they were doing, but they were guarding our house with guns at night. And my father found out about it a little later, and word started leaking out. But at night, men were coming and guarding that house and keeping quiet to the point that we didn't know they were out there with guns.
And that was extremely dangerous.
Yeah.